When I was a young boy, they taught me the rules of chess. They told me that in the opening I have to move all my pieces, and I have to move every piece once. Yesterday, in the sixth game of the match for the World Chess Championship, Carlsen and Caruana made 10 consecutive moves only with the knights. Has the chess changed so much? Let's go to find out. Hello, my friends. Today we will see one of the most difficult games for the World Chess Championship. It's a highly technical game and not easy to understand. We'll try together to see all the fine details. Carlsen is with white and Caruana is with black. So, Carlsen played e4. Now we have the first Petrov defense, the first Russian defense. We spoke also in the last video that Caruana has some success with this opening, so we expect this opening to be played. Carlsen took on e5, d6, and now he played a side variation. He played knight d3. The normal lines are knight f3, knight takes e4, and now this is the main line. Okay, and a lot of games with queen d2 and long castle. Also, the main line many years is this d4 defining bishop d3. White is playing this position. It seems that is a French defense with a tempo less. Let's go to see e4, e6, d4, d5. Exchange French, and when I play knight d3, he can play knight f6. But in this position, in the Russian defense, in the Petrov defense, it is like black played immediately knight e4. See, this is the position for Petrov. But this tempo is not a clear tempo up, because after bishop d3, white will continue with castle and c4, and maybe this knight will have to retreat, so it will be a tempo less, not a tempo more. Okay, also you can play this variation because it is like in the game, we will see, but this is not something special because black has to find an easy way after the move bishop 7, knight c3, 6, long castle, and knight a6. And black is quite fine with knight c7. Has a very stable position. White can try something like d4, but it's not much. So, in the game, Carlsen tried knight d3. This is a little bit strange, but it was played. Okay, is not a new move, of course. We are very early in the opening. Black took on e4, queen e2, and queen e7. Now, a game of show with Caruana. Knight c3 was played. Knight f6 and b3. Okay, bishop 6, bishop b2, bishop f5. Now, bishop is threatening to take on d3. Sometimes, not immediately. Knight f4, long castle, exchange on e7. It was a quite equal game after bishop 7, took on g6, and in this position, Caruana equalized with the move g5. It's very important to understand that when you have double pawns, you need to take some space with the double pawns to play g5, f6, or f5, okay? Because if they can be stabilized, they are weak. That's why Caruana played g5. He continued with the simple plan, c6, d5, f6, and bishop d6. It was an equal position. Another game between grandmasters was playing in the game of Gleck with Ivanchuk. Gleck tried b3 without knight c3 first, but this seems not to be quite okay for white. Ivanchuk played knight c6, bishop b2, bishop b5, and now Gleck played aggressively with g4. After bishop d7, bishop g2, long castle and castle, this is a very strong move, and black was clearly better because of the square d4 and the weakness on g4. Okay? So, in the game, Carlsen played knight f4. The idea, obviously, is to go to d5. Now, a game of Motilev with Rachmanov, two grandmaster with a rating more than 2600, knight f6 was played, d4, knight c6, c3 because the pawn was hanging, f3, bishop g7, h4, e5, knight a3, knight b5, but it's nothing. Okay? It was an equal position. So Caruana tried the knight c6. And now we see that they will play a lot of moves with the knights only. But there is a meaning behind this move. Knight d5 and knight d4. This is the best move. Okay? And the only move, because the queen cannot move away. Because white, after knight d5, threatening the queen, c7 and e4. It's 3 points. So the queen is overloaded. After knight d4, white took on e7, took on e2, and now knight d5. We see now this is the best move. And it's not easy for white to prove an advantage. Let's see, if knight takes e7, king d8 simply, took the rook, then check. You see, this is not good because after knight take a1, the knight f2 is hanging all the time. It is better for black. That's why white has to play the king on e2, but as you see, this king on e2 gives the advantage to black. Bishop d3 played 2 times, and both times black took on f2. It's quite stupid because in this position white is winning with a lot of ways. b3, rook e1, okay, a piece more. I don't understand how to play this knight. Knight c5 is the best move, of course, and it seems that it's okay for black. If white takes on c7, knight takes on a8. Black can take on d3, knight c2, take on a1. b3, white's idea is to take the knight, okay? And now bishop e6. Bishop b2, and now be careful, okay? This is not a good move, because black lose time just to take a pawn. After a king e2 and bishop e7, the knight go out. The white wins, okay? So, king d7, the best move, king c2, now black cannot move the bishop because this pawn is hanging, so rook g8, bishop d4 and bishop b7, with counter chances, okay? So, in this position, Carlsen tried a new move. He played knight a3. And of course, Caruana reacted with the best. Knight e6. Now, knight b5 is nothing because king d8 and all the time a6, c6 is a threat. f3, knight g5. And when you move, the knight c6 is quite fine for black. White has no time to play this h4. f3 was played, knight c5, and d4. Now, also this is interesting, because if you take on c5, black can take on d5, take, we'll have an isolated for black, but this knight on a3, not so good. Okay, if you play knight b5, bishop b5 is very good. If you play bishop e3, then white, black can take on a3, and he has good counter chances, because white has the bishop pair, but black has this damaged own structure. So, knight d7 was played. Okay, solid from Caruana, of course. e3, c6, knight f4, knight b6. Seems that black has no problem. Okay, all this match, black never has a problem only in one Rosolimo that Caruana let his advantage evaporate very quickly. Bishop d3, d5. Now we see that coming, so the knight, and we have this French type position. Okay, Petrov or French exchange. Okay, this position is just a position to play chess. As you can imagine, this is what's going on all this match. Carlsen was trying to go out of theory as early as he can and to play some position with chances, but until now with white doesn't show any advantage. And Caruana played h5. It's quite an interesting move because black wants to take some space with h4. Normal to play h4, and now this knight c8 has the idea to go to e7 and to exchange the bad bishop from e6, okay, with bishop f5. Caruana cannot allow this. Knight e7, and now I like very much the way that Caruana played c5. Okay, he's not playing boring, and he tried to make something out of opening. If white take on c5, then black is quite okay because the knight now it's pinned. If they move the knight, d4 equalize the position. Caruana played bishop c2, bishop c2, castle, rook d1, rook fd8, and knight g2. Here you see now that the idea is, of course, to play d4, and black took on d4. Generally, this pawn formation changed again now, okay? This pawn formation arises also from the queen's gambit declined. The most famous game is Botvinnik Petrosyan, the 14th game in Moscow from the World Chess Championship, 1963. Of course, it's not the same because there were queens in the chess board. Now, this position is without queens. But most of the time, this position can arise from queen's gambit decline also. So, c takes on d4, rook c8, bishop b3, and now black played the knight to come to a5. Bishop f4, knight a5, take the bishop. If you take on d6, I can. Maybe I can take on b3 and play rook b6, but also I can take immediately and double on the c line. So, rook c1, and now of course a very good move from Caruana. He doesn't want to exchange his good bishop for bad one on 4, and he played bishop b4. Okay, according to the pawn on the center, we have a good and a bad bishop. So in this position for white, the bad bishop is the f4 bishop, and for black, the bad bishop is the e6 bishop. Now he played bishop d1. He can try this, but he doesn't like the position because here, okay, knight f4 is nothing because bishop f5 is quite okay. And when you take bishop d2, bishop h6 is very good because black are threatening this bishop e6. This is hanging. The c line cannot be controlled by white, and also the rook has to come on c2, so this is better for black. But has to play rook take a7, bishop d6, and now it's a forced line. You take bishop, rook e7, take. Black has some chances, but I think objectively this is equal. b4. Now, if you play rook a7, it's interesting. Come to a2, then knight f4, rook a2, take on d5, king e3. Check. Now you see this is bad because the d-pawn is very strong, so you have to go to f8, check, give this pawn, and a lot of pawns are exchanged, so it's not cannot have any advantage. Black, it's quite an equal position. Okay, so maybe he can try this bishop rook d7 after b4, but I think also black can keep the white can keep the position with normal moves. Okay, of course bishop d1 is also has a point. He doesn't want to give the bishop. The bishop can come to e2. Also targeting x-ray this h5 sometimes, we will see later. Knight c4, b3. Now also we can come to d6, but the same will be played, I think. Caruana played knight a3. Rook c8, exchange. Now, bishop e3, not so easy. You have to be, it's interesting also because he want to play this knight f4 now, and if black play bishop c3, this is not a good move. Rook c1, knight b5, comes this bishop e2, and white is fine because you cannot take on d4 because I have rook take on c3, and the knight on d4 is hanging. So rook c1 was played, knight b5, and we have clearly an equal position. But generally, as we see, there are some weaknesses on the dark square. The c3 square is black can take with a lot of pieces. The knight can come, the bishop can come also. So it is more easy, I think, for black to play this position. But objectively, it's equal. Carlsen played knight e3. Okay, maybe interesting, maybe dubious. I'm not sure because what to play? Bishop e3 is not easy to play the knight on f4 because bishop f5. Knight f4, now there are some initiative for black. White can keep the position, but only with this move. Knight takes a2 and bishop d2. So, the exchange, they want to exchange the bad bishop and to take one of these pawns. So, knight c3 and knight take h5. I think also bishop b8 is quite normal. a6, knight f4. Again, with tempo to go. Play bishop b8 with tempo to have this knight f4, bishop c3, take, take, and check, and king g2. It is also an equal position. So Carlsen tried to play something to take something of the position, but objectively, this is better. Only black can play here. Black has a lot of interesting ideas now. He can play even bishop e6 simply, knight c2. Not this. Have some ideas to put pressure on the d4 pawn. Not easy. Also, this is interesting all the time. Okay, but also bishop e2, quite okay. And bishop d2, because now we pin the knight, bishop a5 is hanging. If black played bishop on c3, then also this is quite a normal move. Take. Take, take, and now this is a very easy draw because he take, king take, it's very difficult to have anything in this position because of the opposite color bishops. And if black go to c6, bishop c5, so the king, the black king cannot come quickly in the center. If f6, this is a threat, it is completely equal. Okay, so a6. Has the idea to stop this bishop b5, but I think also white can have compensation with the two bishop for a draw. He will exchange pieces with b5, pawns with b5, sorry, knight e5, king d3, king d4, and I think it's quite close to a draw also. But bishop e6 is also interesting. In the game was played knight c3. Bishop c2. Now, this is not good, of course. There is no reason to exchange this pawn with d5. Bishop a5 also. Bishop d6. And bishop c5. Not easy to make a progress. Take the pawn and white take the pawn. So, quite normal that I like this move that Caruana played. This bishop a3. Now a2 is under attack all the time. White has to play energetically to find some play, play d4. Now after bishop d7, f5, and bishop c6, the position I think is slightly better for black. White played bishop d1. Now, maybe black has to take, but can play f6. The idea also that this f pawn can be under attack, but black has a small advantage, but also it's not easy to make something concrete out of it. Bishop c1, bishop d7. The idea to exchange these two pawns, but white can play king f3. And even if you take the pawn, it's nothing again. Okay, so bishop b2 was playing. Also, this idea all the time, this was an interesting idea to take the a2 pawn. Okay, if you take bishop b2, bishop a7, knight c3, with the idea of knight d4 or sometimes with knight b5, it's also interesting. Caruana played bishop b2. Now, if bishop a7, bishop c1 and check is interesting. Here, knight f6, and when you play g4, this is an interesting idea to play g6. The bishop has some problems, but also take on a2, it's interesting. Bishop take h5, knight c3, this knight b5 is coming here, and just keep the position. Okay, so this interesting, but it seems that bishop c1 is good after bishop a7. So Carlsen played bishop take h5. Now all the time this idea has to be analyzed. Okay, here it seems better also for black, slowly, slightly, and slowly. This game is very slow. Bishop a7, knight c3. Now if you go to b6, the same again, and but now we see a lot of ideas. The f5 hanging, knight c8 is coming, and on bishop c5 there is b6. So then I have to protect d4. It's also slightly in black's favor. So if bishop e2, also check, knight d2, you have to keep the b3 pawn, bishop d1 and b5, and bishop c3 with the idea a5 is better for black. That's why maybe take on a2 now was better than knight e4. After knight e4, king g2, bishop takes d4, bishop f4, and bishop c5, have the first interesting position. Okay, because now the pawn structure has changed, everyone can have a passed pawn. Black already has a passed pawn, white will have a passed pawn, so that's why black is slightly better. This is an interesting idea that was not analyzed a lot in the internet. Has some ideas with knight g4, knight d5, or with g4, and on d4, not knight c4, because it seems strong, because knight a5 or e5 is coming, but this is quite good. Knight king f2, and now d3, king e1, and knight 4 gives the initiative to play. So after bishop d1, d4, knight g4. And now if f6, this is a good idea to equalize. This is interesting. But it seems that white can keep also the position. Knight d5 has the idea of knight d3 or to take the bishop, but bishop d2, knight c3, bishop f3, or white has the tempo b7 and can keep the position. So the best move after knight g4 is bishop d7. And now f6 is an interesting idea to create a passed pawn. The best for black is to take the pawn, so to stabilize the knight on e4 with f5. Bishop f3, bishop c6, knight f2, f5, knight d3, and bishop b6. This is a slightly better position for black. Okay, the pawn more is important only for the protection of the knight on e4, but white has also a passed pawn. So in the game was played bishop f3, quite a normal move, knight d2, and this is a very good idea that Carlsen played here, bishop takes on d5. Knight f1. Not good because black has the two bishops and they can come with the bishop to d3. This is a mistake because we don't want to close the light squares here. When we have the two bishops, all the progress will be made, as we said in the previous some previous video, from the squares that the bishop that our opponent doesn't has a bishop. We have two bishops and we have a light square bishop, so we want the light squares to be opened. Okay, that's why d3 is a bad move. White can keep the position. The best is to put the bishop on d3 to play on the light squares, because this bishop is playing on his own. And after something like g4, b5, it's clearly for black. That's why Carlsen played a very good move, but he didn't calculate well. It was a little bit lucky here, because he gave a pawn, pieces for two pawns now, for three pawns, but he doesn't show that he will lose one. So after this move, knight e4 is coming, and now, okay, this is an interesting idea, to mobilize the passed pawn on the queen side. Knight h5, a check on e4 is threatened, king e3, and to blockade the pawns in king e4. This is also interesting for white. It seems white has counter chances too. But this is that the idea that Carlsen saw, but didn't show a very good move here from Caruana. Bishop a3, and there is no 3 pawns for the pieces, but only 2, because the a2 pawn will be lost. Carlsen said in the press conference that he missed this move. Bishop c4, king f8, c5, knight c3. And very good idea, b4. Because white wants to keep the a pawn, that is far away. Okay? Quite logical decision. Knight a5, knight c5. It seems that white, it's very difficult for black to win position. Let's see what happens, and the right place for the on the king side, because this a pawn, if black wants to win, he has to go to the king, take this pawn, but then the white king will exchange all the pawns to the other side. So knight e4, king h5, bishop e1, bishop d3, knight d6, and very good idea. So the white king can come to g6 to create a fortress. Bishop take on a5, take, take, and king g6. And we have this position. This is a very interesting position. A very difficult position. Let's see what we have to do. The first thing is, when white can put the pawn on h6, the king. So the idea is this, the king to move around. Okay, and not easy to come for the black king to f7, because has to play a check. We'll see all this in detail, don't get confused. And to see how we do something with the king on g8 or f7, what white will allow. Okay, so now Carlsen play a very good move. King h7 is a very strong move. If he move h5, then after king g8, I think black is winning. Let's see how. H6, then knight can come on d4. It's very easy to come on d4. And the idea is to come to e. This is the critical square. Check, check, king h8. And knight e5. The king come to h7, and slowly the pawn will be lost. Okay, that's why king h7 is the best idea. Knight f7, bishop c4, knight e5, of course, bishop a5, h5, and bishop d2. Bishop e2, a2, knight f3, bishop d5, knight d4, bishop g5, and we have this position. This position was calculated to a win. Okay, from a computer, from a supercomputer. I saw the idea, I see I show the idea and how to explain to you, because it is not easy. Let's go. The idea was to play bishop h4, bishop d5, knight e2. I want to put the knight on e4. No, after bishop f3, knight g1. You move, and in this position, okay, I want to put the knight on g3. This is the good square. I want to put the knight on g3, so to see how white will keep these two pawns. For example, knight e2, bishop f3, knight g4, bishop g4. If king g6 was played, then as we showed before, king g8 is winning like in the previous variation. So bishop g4. Now the bishop has to keep the pawn, so he can come to f7. If you move the knight, the bishop to give check, I can take the pawn. Check king f8, go out, knight h4, black wins. So the bishop cannot move. So white has to wait with the king. Bishop b3, king h7, bishop c5. Now, if he go with the bishop and take again, bishop b3 check, king e7, king g6, knight h4, king g7, and f5. It seems that black is winning now. Check and f4. Bishop d5 to keep the pawn. Bishop b2, h7, and now two interesting ideas. The first one is this idea. You see that the bishop is not easy to take because white will be mate it. But what else to play? Bishop e4, king f6. Now you have to move. How? If you play king f8, check. Here I just win because you give the bishop and you cannot take my bishop because your king is not near the promotion of the white pawn. So you have to go back, knight g6. And now there is a problem, because knight e7 is coming, mate, and you cannot promote. And if you take the knight, you lose the f pawn. So you have to take the bishop, king f7, check, king f8, bishop e4, f3. If you take, it's mate on g6, but if you wait, I give the pawn, I make. So in this position, you cannot move the knight and give the f5 pawn. So you play king h8. Then bishop f8 and knight d4. I'm threatening to mate you. Knight g5 and bishop g7. 6, knight g5. Take the pawn. Bishop g7. Without the bishop on h5, it will be stalemate, but this is not possible. This is the problem with the opposite color bishop. You cannot sacrifice very easily. So, of course, this is extremely difficult, as you can understand. And knight f3 was played. King h7, knight e5. Ideas now. Bishop b3, because we see a lot of moves. It seems that it's easy for white to make a draw. Not at all. Knight g4 and knight e3. Now, Carlsen played the best move, this bishop d3, because this bishop has to keep the knight not to come to g3 square. If he goes something like this, I think this position is quite a huge one, because white can only move this idea. Now knight f1, knight g3, king g6, and knight e2, because all the time the bishop will come to this e6 square to keep the pawn, and this knight e2 is with tempo. H6, check, and bishop g5. Now where to move? If the king moves, the h6 pawn will be lost. Bishop a2, okay, and now knight g2, knight e3, pawn is under attack. King g6, knight g4, I threat the pawn on h6, h7, check, and the pawn is lost. You can keep for some moves, but you have to play now. Also Zugzwang, move the king, knight c6, king g4, and knight d4. And you see that all the pieces of white are overloaded. The bishop has to the h7 pawn, the knight, the king has to keep the 5 pawn, and white is in Zugzwang and will lose. That's why bishop d3 is a very good move. Now, if king x7, you cannot have the previous position. Bishop b1, knight f1. Now the bishop, the king is on f7, and this is check. Only the bishop c4 move. If you play bishop e6, is the previous line. If you go to g6, I have this knight e3 again. Now, if you move, have bishop h4 and the same knight g2. If you play h6, I have knight g4 to show, knight e5 and king g7. But you have this only move, and the knight has to decide. If you come here, is the same position. If you come to g3, now it's not the same because I play this. And the idea is that if you come to try the same ideas, I have h6. Even here or even here, to come to f2 and g4 and e5, this h6 make the draw. So after knight g4, bishop c4, knight h6, black break the king, but nothing, and it was a draw because now knight g4, 3, knight e3, and the same h6 idea. Bishop takes h6, king takes, and the draw was agreed. It was a very technical game, and the level of this championship is not easy to understand. Okay, except the first game. There was a lot of mistakes in the first game, but after, it's a very high quality all chess. Good night, my friends, and we will wait for the next.